up guys, welcome back to my channel and to another video. As you can see behind me, there is a little bit of snow. Actually there is quite some snow high up in the mountains, considering it's mid-October basically. So today I'm going to spend the night in my tent in a place called Punta Lastoi de Formin. It's a place that not many people visit actually, but it's a really great viewpoint towards Pelmo on one side and most of the Dolomites on the west. So yeah, there's gonna be quite some snow, so I'm really excited for this first winter camping adventure. So yeah, let's go! So good to see snow again.
Val Formin.
I met some guys who were going down with snowshoes. And they told me that it's impossible to get on top without snowshoes and that there's no trace. We'll see. So let me show you why I really love this place. We are right below the western face of Croda del Lago. It's quite a famous mountain. You can see it from lots of places in the Dolomites. It's very recognizable, all these sharp pinnacles. But not many people know that there is a valley right below, and it's just amazing.
It's not that easy.
It's getting pretty hard now. All this part is full of rocks and the snow is super fresh, so every step you just go down to the ground in the holes between the rocks, so it's pretty tiring and also like psychologically frustrating.
This is not good. It can be really risky. You can break a leg doing this, so I need to be super careful. Oh fuck,
alright, this part is really hard. Every step I'm going down like half a meter, so light is coming. I'm quite late for sunset, so the plan is stopping here, I'm gonna fly the drone and then we'll see. Thank you. sunset light has been short, but pretty cool. I'm not really sure about what to do because this terrain is really bad. It's terrible to go up because the snow is getting more and more thick, and still every step you go down in the holes, it's also dangerous, and there's a lot to reach the saddle, for example. So what I was thinking, I could reach this little plateau over here, and that's a good spot for setting a tent. I've already camped in winter over there, but first of all, it would probably take me like, I don't know, 30 minutes for 50 meters, because it's really, it's almost impossible to go up. The guys were right. And then if I was camping there, I should hike to the saddle at least for sunrise, because from here there is no view towards east. So I'm not really sure about staying here for the night. I don't think it makes much sense, so I think I'm going down. Yeah, I think it's a good solution. And then sunrise tomorrow. Oh fuck, I am so stupid, I should have brought my snowshoes. Alright, I'm here in my sleeping bag. It's actually a new one from Marmot. It's called Payu. It's a winter bag, so outside it's 3 degrees. Probably it will drop till 0 or -1, so I'll be super, super comfortable. Tomorrow morning the plan is to leave very early at around 5 to shoot sunrays, of course. I'm gonna meet with Andrea, a friend of mine who lives at 45 minutes from here. So we're gonna meet in the night, hike up to the spot. We're not sure about where, so it will be a surprise for you and for me. And yeah, let's hope for some nice colors. So, good night. Welcome to Mondeval. The sun has started to light up the peaks all around. It's amazing. so crazy to see how much snow there's here. I mean, it's mid-October and looks like January. It's time to go down.
And the car is over there.
Alright, so that's pretty much it for this video. I drove a little lower than Paso Jao because it was so crowded. So I think I'm gonna go home because I have quite some office work to do, and I'll be back in the Dolomites in just 3 or 4 days for a workshop. So I really hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and see you in the next adventure.